This video shows laboratory workers how to respond to a single broken mercury thermometer. If more than one thermometer breaks, or you have any other kind of mercury spill, evacuate the room and get assistance, especially if the spill happens in a warm room or a heated device. Enjoy the demonstration.
Shoot! This is the second mercury thermometer I've broken this week. Tim, I need your help. Nope, don't, please don't walk through there. Just if you could walk around and keep people out of the room, that would be really helpful.
Okay.
I saw EH&S clean this up last week. I think I can handle it, but you know, maybe we'll clean it up. Maybe we'll have to call them, okay? Just if you could put a sign up, that would be great.
I got a broom and a dustpan.
You know, that'll just contaminate the broom and the dustpan, so we're not going to use that. What we need is just some paper right now to pick up the visible mercury. Actually, this jar right here will work perfectly. We're going to scoop the mercury in the glass up with just two pieces of paper, and just be careful of the droplets of mercury because they do tend to spread. If you can see here, there's little balls all over the place.
Yeah.
And I'm going to take these two pieces of paper and...
I am so glad I didn't break this in the incubator. That would have vaporized the mercury too much, and we couldn't have done this ourselves.
Finding a couple of the bigger bees, but sometimes the little ones get shoved under the cracks. Yeah, I don't know if it went under there or not. I hope not. But that looks pretty good. You see anything else right here? All right. Now, some people are really afraid of mercury vapors, but this is such a small amount, and we got it contained pretty quickly. I think that we don't have much to worry about in that regard, but we don't want it to be sitting here in the lab for extended periods of time. We just want to make sure we get most of it, if not all of it, up, and if we're not comfortable, we'll call EH&S. You think we did a good job, or should we call EH&S?
Looks good to me.
Looks good to you? You know, it does look pretty good, but since I've never done this before, I think I'd feel more comfortable if EH&S came in.
Okay.
So do you want to give them a call and tell them we had a mercury thermometer break, and maybe they can bring out some of that monitoring equipment, make sure...
Like a Geiger counter or something?
Yes, I don't think that's it, but something like that.
All right, I'll give them a call.
All right, thanks.
Is this where the mercury spill was?
Yes. Are you from EH&S?
Yeah. I have my mercury vapor detector. Can you show me where the spill is right there?
Right here, and it spilled just in that one area. I dropped the thermometer right there, and it fell right on the ground. So I imagine just a mercury thermometer, I wasn't really exposed that much, because I cleaned it up pretty quickly. Does that be correct?
The meter says that there isn't any elevated levels of mercury here. You're right. And I'll check the area. Was it sort of in this general area?
Right in here.
Okay.
You could use a flashlight, but it wasn't very strong.
All right. Yeah, it seems like you did a pretty good job. Is this the waste here?
That's the waste. And I used a pipette. And I used duct tape, and I started out with those cards there to get up the initial beads. Was that the way to do it?
Yeah, great.
Okay.
Well, you could put that waste in the hood if you wanted, or just have it picked up as chemical waste. Okay, is there anything else I can do here?
I think that looks good. I just wanted to make sure. So thank you very much for coming.
All right. Bye-bye.
Bye. Thank you.